Hello guys, welcome back to Chanda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a wave post leaf top. It is a wearable top which is comfortable and the stitches is really stretching, and we have the front button so it is easy to wear and take it off. For this top, it is friendly for beginners and really easy to make. Just the two rows repeat. And for this top, I made for size small. And for you guys that make different size, I'll be showing you how to make it bigger and longer in this video. Okay, now let's get into the video. For this top, I use milk cotton yarn, size 5 ply. I use 3 colors. It is 50 gram for each, and I use with 3.5 mm crochet hook. If you don't have cotton yarn, you can use any type and any size of yarn, and the crochet hook that fit with your yarn size. First thing first, we are going to make the bust part, which is the crop top part. To begin, make a slip knot. Next, we are going to make the foundation chain by multiple of 12 plus 5. For my top, I made 126 chains. It is equal 25 inches. It's the measurement around my under bust. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more chains by multiple of 12 and then plus 5. Make sure that you make it a little bit bigger than your under bust. If you guys confusing about the foundation chains why I made it really short, it is just a sample showing you how to make the wave stitch. Like I said, if you guys want your top bigger, please add more chains by multiple of 12 plus 5 until it a little bit bigger than your under bust. After you got your desired fit, next we are going to make the wave stitch. For row 1, skip 3 chains and make the bulk crochet into the first chain. To make the bulk crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Remember, for chain 3 also count as a stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then skip 1 chain and make the bulk crochet into the next chain. After you have made a double crochet, then skip 1 chain and make the bulk crochet into the next 2 stitches. After you have made 2 stitches of the bulk crochet, then we are going to make increase into the next stitch by make 5 double crochet into the same loop. After you got 5 double crochet in the same loop, then we are going to make the bulk crochet into the next 2 stitches. After After you have made two double crochets, then we are going to make decrease by skip one chain and make double crochet into the next chain. Keep repeating this for three more times. Skip one chain and make double crochet into the next chain. This is two. This is three. And this is four. After you got four stitches, then make a double crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then we are going to make increase again into the next stitch by make 5 double crochet in the same loop. After you have made 5 double crochet in the same loop, then we are going to keep repeating this set until you have one last stitch and we meet you back again. After you have one last stitch, then we are going to make double crochet and change the color. After you got two loops on your hook, then drop the pink yarn and grab the new color. Yarn over and push through two loops. And next, cut off the pink yarn. And this is what the first row of the wave stitch looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 1. Turn your work. Remember, chain 1 don't count as a stitch. Next, we are going to make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Don't forget to carry these two strands of yarn along with the row. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through two loops. Keep making single crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch. Then I will meet you back again. After you have one last stitch, it is the chain 3 stitch. Then we are going to make single crochet and change the color. After you got two loops on your hook, then drop the blue yarn and cut it off. And next, bring the new color. Yarn over and pull through two loops. Next, for row 3, chain 3. Like I said, chain 3 also counts as a stitch. Turn your work. For this stitch that near chain 3, we are going to skip it because this stitch is for the chain 3 stitch. Then we are going to make double crochet but into the back loop of the stitch only into the next stitch. As you can see this V shape here, and we are going to insert the hook into the back loop of the stitch only. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And this is how we made a double crochet back loop only. After you have made a double crochet back loop only, then skip 1 stitch and make the double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. After you have made a double crochet back loop only, then skip 1 stitch and make the double crochet back loop only into the next 2 stitches. And now you got 5 double crochet include the chain 3 stitch. Next, we are going to make increase by make 5 double crochet back loop only into the same loop. After you got 5 double crochet back loop only in the same loop, then we are going to make double crochet back loop only into the next 2 stitches. After you have made 2 double crochet back loop only, then we are going to make decrease by skip 1 stitch and make double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. Keep repeating this for 3 more times. In total, you must have 4 stitches of decrease. Next, make double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. Then we are going to make increase again by make 5 double crochet back loop only into the same loop. After you got 5 double crochet back loop only in the same loop, then we are going to keep repeating this set until you have 1 last stitch and I will meet you back again. After you have 1 last stitch, then we are going to make double crochet into both loop as you can see, and then change the color. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 23. It is equal 7.5 inches high. If you guys want your top more longer, please add more rows by repeat row 2 and row 3. Then I will meet you back again. this is what my top looks like after I reach row 23. This is the wrong side of the top, and this is the right side of the top. After you reach your desired fit, don't forget to chain one and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the button part. But first, we have to make single crochet around this edge. We are going to working on the right side of the top. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner stitch. And then chain one. Next, for row one, make two single crochet into this big loop of double crochet row. After you have made two single crochet in the double crochet row, and then we are going to make a single crochet into this single crochet row. Next, make single crochet into this very small loop above this big loop. It is on top of the double crochet stitch, as you can see. Next, make single crochet into this big loop, which is the double crochet row. For the next stitch, please keep repeating the same thing until you reach the corner. Then I will meet you back again. This is what it looks like after you reach the corner. Next, we are going to continue make single crochet into this part. Make single crochet into the same loop with this double crochet stitch. And then we are going to make single crochet into this chain space. For the next stitch, we are going to make single crochet into the double crochet stitch and into the chain space until you reach the other side corner. Then I will meet you back again. For this increasing part, we only make a single crochet. This is what it looks like after you have made single crochet around the edge until you reach the other side corner. For the bottom edge of the top, which is the wave part, we are not made single crochet into it. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the corner. Then we meet you back again. After you reach the corner, next we are going to make the buttonholes. You can make 4 or 5 or more buttonholes, it's up to your top. If it's longer, please add more buttonholes. You can count the number of the stitches of your row and try to divide them by 5 if you use 5 buttonholes. For my top, I count 1 stitches from the corner and then use stitch marker mark at the second stitch. For the next buttonhole, count 8 stitches and use stitch marker to mark at the 8th stitch and keep counting the same number until you reach the end of the row. Make sure that you leave 1 or 2 stitches at the end of the row. Next, continue from where your last stitch is for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make a single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. And now you reach the stitch marker, we are going to chain 2. Then skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 6 stitches. And this is what the buttonhole looks like. If you use bigger button, please add more chain and skip more stitches. Example, if you make 3 chain, then you have to skip 3 stitches the same. After you reach the stitch marker, then chain 2. Skip 2 stitches and make single crochet into the next 6 stitches. Keep repeating the same thing until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. As you can see, for the last buttonhole, I have 1 last stitch remain, then make single crochet into that last stitch. Next, for row 4, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Then make 2 single crochet into the chain space. And next, keep making single crochet into every stitch until you reach the chain space, and then make 2 single crochet into the chain space. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 5, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. this is what it looks like. When I try to put the button into the buttonhole, you have to make the buttonhole a little bit smaller than the button, so the button will stay in place. Next, we are going to make single crochet into the other side's edge. Turn your top and we are going to working on the wrong side of the top or the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part. And then chain 1. For row 1, make single crochet into the same stitch with chain 1. And continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. For row 2 until row 5, just chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. And now we are done for the button part. Place this buttonhole part on top of the regular part. And next, we are going to sewing the button into the regular part. I use thread and needle to sewing the button. Because the hole in my button, it is really small, it only fit with the needle and thread. If you use different button, which is the darning needle and yarn can fit through, you can use it. Keep sewing button into the top until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after I have buttoned up the top. As you can see, for this wave pattern, the stitches is really stretching. So you only make it fit and a little bit bigger than your under bust, and the bust part it will fit because the stitches is stretching. When you're wearing this top, you just stretch the bust part and button up. Next, count 15 stitches of single crochet and use stitch marker to mark at the 16th stitch. Please don't forget to count the same number to the other side. If you guys want your chest part more wider, you can count more stitches and mark it. If you want it smaller, please reduce some stitches and mark it. You can try the top on your body first and use stitch marker to mark where you want to make the strap. For the measurement between this both stitch marker, it is equal 7 inches. Next, turn your top and we are going to use stitch marker to mark at the back part of the top. Please mark it at the same spot like the front part. And this is what it looks like. To make sure that both parts are equal, you have to count the number of the stitches at the underarm part. For the space of the measurement at my underarm, I have 28 stitches, which is equal 6 inches. Next, count the same number to the other side. You don't have to include the stitch that you mark, just start counting from the next stitch. For the second side, I have only 24 stitches, so I have to remove the stitch marker and count 4 more stitches and mark at the 5th stitch. For the next part, we are going to make the right side strap. To begin, we are going to attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. And then for row 1, chain 1 and make single crochet into the same stitch with chain 1. Next, continue making single crochet into the next 4 stitches. You must have 5 stitches in total. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 63. It is equal 11.5 inches. If you guys want your strap more longer, please add more rows. If you want it shorter, please reduce some row. And this is what my strap looks like after I reach row 63. And next, we are going to connect the strap into the back part of the top. To begin, flip the strap wrong side out. Then count 4 stitches away from the stitch marker and attach the yarn into the 5th stitch. Continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together by insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through both loops. And now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the right side of the strap looks like. As you can see, this is the space at the underarm part. For the next row, we are going to start from the front strap by turn it. To begin, attach the yarn into the single crochet stitch that near the strap. And then chain 1. Next, we are going to make single crochet into every loop of the single crochet row, which is the strap, until you reach the end of the row or until you reach the corner, then I will meet you back again. after you reach the end of the row. Next, we are going to make slip stitch into the single crochet stitch, which is the underarm part. After you have made slip stitch, and then chain one and cut off the yarn. For the next row, please turn your top. Remember, you always turn your work when you start working the new row. Next, for row 2, count 2 stitches away from the strap, which is the slip stitch part, and then attach the yarn into the third stitch. Then chain 1. For the next part, we are going to make the wave stitch into this row of the strap by repeating the same thing like we've made the wave stitch at the crop top. To begin, make double crochet into the same stitch that you made slip stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then make double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. After you have made a double crochet back loop only, then skip one stitch and make double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. Next, skip one stitch and make double crochet back loop only into the next two stitches. After you have made two double crochet back loop only, next we are going to make increase by make 5 double crochet back loop only into the same stitch. As you can see, it is the same thing like we did at the crop top part. After you have made increase, then make double crochet back loop only into the next two stitches. And next, we are going to make decrease by skip one stitch and make double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. Keep repeating this for 3 more times. After you got 4 double crochet, and then make a double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. And next, we are going to make increase again by make 5 double crochet back loop only into the same stitch. Please keep repeating this set until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. It's okay if your last row end with different stitch not the same like mine, because we make different size. As you can see my last row, I end with 3 double crochets of decrease, and then I make double crochet into this last stitches of the single crochet row, which is the row of the strap. And this is what it looks like. Next, count 2 stitches from the strap part and make slip stitch into the third stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the second row looks like. Next, for row 3, turn your work. And we are going to attach the yarn into the next stitch. then chain 1. Next, we are going to make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next we are going to make slip stitch into the single crochet stitch, which is the underarm part. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the next row, please turn your work, and this is what the third row looks like, and this is what the underarm part looks like. Next, for row 4, we are going to attach the yarn on top of the first double crochet stitch. As you can see, this is the first double crochet stitch and the single crochet stitch on top of the double crochet stitch. We are going to attach the yarn into the single crochet stitch then on top the double crochet stitch. Next, chain 3. Like I said, chain 3 also counts as a stitch. For the next stitch, we are going to make the wave stitch but repeat the same thing like we did at the second row, but we only working the stitch into the back loop only. As you can see, now I have 5 double crochet include the chain 3 stitch, and then we are going to make increase by make 5 double crochet back loop only into the same stitch. After you have made increase, then make double crochet back loop only into the next 2 stitches. Next, we are going to make decrease by skip 1 stitch and make double crochet back loop only into the next stitch. Keep repeating this for 3 more times. After you got 4 double crochet, then make a double crochet into the next stitch. And next, make increase by make 5 double crochet back loop only in the same stitch. Please keep repeating this set until you reach the corner, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner, and this is what it looks like. As you can see, I already made 3 double crochet of decrease, so I have to make 1 more decrease into the underarm part. So when you're working the stitch into the underarm part, you don't have to pick the back loop only, just pick both loops. After I got 4 double crochet of decrease, then make another double crochet into the next stitch. And next, make increase by make 5 double crochet into the same stitch. Keep making 5 stitches until you reach the chain 3 stitch, then I will meet you back again. And now I had reached the end of the row. For my last row, I end with 4 double crochets of the crease. Like I said, it's okay if you end with different stitch. If you end with increasing stitch, it's okay. And if you end with the decreasing stitch like mine, it's okay too. Because we made different size, so your sleeve might be bigger than mine or smaller than mine, like that. Next, we are going to make slip stitch to connect the row. Count 2 chains and make slip stitch into the 3rd chain. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the 4th row looks like. For the next row, please turn your work. Next, for row 5, attach the yarn into the loop that behind the slip stitch. And then chain 1. Next, make single crochet into the same stitch with chain 1. And then we are going to continue make single crochet into this double crochet stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the 1st single crochet stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the 5th row of the wave stitch looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 4 and row 5 until you reach row 16. Then we meet you back again. As you can see, this chain 3 we also count as a stitch. So you have to attach the yarn on top of this chain 3 stitch. And then chain 3 and keep repeating the same thing like row 4 and row 5. As you can see, for my last row, I end with 3 double crochet of decrease. So I have to add one more row into the next stitch to make it equal like the fourth row. Make sure that you don't miss the stitch, so your sleeve will keep decreasing. You have to count the number of your stitches. In every row, you must have the same number of the stitches. And this is what my sleeves looks like after I reach row 16. If you guys want your sleeve longer, please add more rows by repeat row 4 and row 5. For the next part, we are going to make decrease around the sleeves. To begin, for row 17, attach the yarn and chain 1. And then make single crochet into the same stitch with chain 1. Next, skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the next stitch. Please keep repeating this by skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the next stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then make slip stitch. Next, for row 18, chain 1, turn your work, make single crochet, and then skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Keep repeating this by skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the next 4 stitches around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After after you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. And this is what my armhole looks like. If it is too small with your arm, please make less decreasing stitch by reduce some decreasing stitch in your row. Next, for row 18 and row 20, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then make slip stitch. This is what the right side sleeves looks like. After you reach row 20, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the left sleeve. But repeat the same thing like the right sleeve. It is just a little bit different at the strap part. To begin, attach the yarn into the 5th stitch from the stitch marker. And then chain 1. Next, for row 1, make single crochet until you reach the stitch marker. It is equal 5 stitches of single crochet. After you reach the stitch marker, next, for row 2 until row 63, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. After you reach row 63, next we are going to attach the strap into the back part of the top. To begin, flip the strap wrong side out and make single crochet both sides together by start attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the wrong side and the right side looks like. And this is the underarm part. After you reach the end of the row, you don't have to cut off the yarn. Just continue make slip stitch into the next single crochet stitch, which is the underarm part. After you have made slip stitch, then turn your work. Next, start from row 1 until row 20. Please repeat the same thing like the right sleeves. Then we meet you back again. Now both sleeves are done. And this is what the front part and the back part of the top looks like. To support the sleeves not to fall off from your shoulder, you just make the long foundation chains enough and then attach the chains or the lace into the strap as you can see in this picture and then tie them together. The sleeves is not gonna fall off again. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.